guys, welcome back to Detroit Garage. On this episode, we're going to continue breaking in the silver 453T. I've increased the size of injectors in them. I've got a kind of a mix of injectors as I covered on the last video. They're basically 80 cc or millimeters per 1000 injectors. So that's a fair increase from the 60 cc injectors that were in it before. Basically spent the week, if I can believe that, but it has been a week, putting in add-ons for the dyno. So I put in an EGT sensor or probe. I put a port in here as well, right here, for the back pressure for the turbo drive pressure. I put an adapter in here for airbox pressure. I got old Delco running. This came off a junk engine. I can't remember where from, but believe it or not, it works. So we'll be running that on the dyno. I fixed the turbo boot or the turbo pipe. I welded on a lip here so that can't blow off anymore. And we got a block heater working. I plugged Jimmy in, warm him up. I replaced the fan hub on the last video. Gee, I got 1.2 hours and shredded the belts. I had to shut the dyno down. So we fixed that. Drilled and tapped a boost pressure sensor for the turbo boost. My gauges haven't shown up yet. They're supposed to come with the muffler. So what we have is that digital tack. Forgot to bring that Velcro sticky stuff, so we'll have to sort that out. But anyway, we'll have a digital tack for now. And what you see here, so we'll have EGT, we've got oil, we've got water temperature, oil pressure, volts, hours, and turbo boost. And then we'll have eventually airbox and oil temp. So fix the Morris controls so they're proper now with this unit here, so we can get that sorted. This will be the last outdoor session for the dyno. Thanks for that gentleman who suggested running the exhaust through the stove. That's a great idea, but the stove's in session and I'm not sure how that's gonna work, but I have an exhaust fan up there in the ceiling, so I'll adapt something for that, and then I'll set the dyno up here, get rid of all this stuff, store it outside I suppose, and then get the dyno set up inside, and then that way I can keep the neighbors happy, I can stay warm, and everybody's a winner on that one. So anyway, let me get this sorted out. I'll get this stuff set up and we'll do a dyno session. The dyno for this session is just testing these 80 millimeter injectors, and I'll try to do a horsepower run. I'll have to figure that out, to be honest, because I have no software on this unit. I just have manual controls. So I'll try my best to figure out what a, you know, a good horsepower is at 2500 RPM or something. Anyway, let's get to it, guys.
Let's give them two extra.
This one here?
Yep. And then your win.
All right, guys. We got everything hooked up. Got the water running for the dyno. So we'll fire Jimmy up and start running some runs on the dyno, warm him up. And again, I don't have the final gauges in here. I've got the torque gauge and the RPM, and then we've got EGTs, water temp, oil pressure, boost, voltage, and the hour meter. Bear with me, I'll get something sorted out for the next dyno run when I get better gauges and everything. So Jimmy ran really nice. The turbo now, without an intercooler, you can see a bit of black smoke coming out with max fuel and a max load. Very nice. The two 7E75s are putting out more fuel than the 7A77s. These two ports are about 100 degrees hotter than the front two. So, just an observation. But for the next dyno, I'll be putting 9E85s in. So with any luck, some of these gauges worked out okay. And you guys can read something here, so. Anyway, for the next dyno run, it'll be inside. Yeah, another hour down and I am freezing. It's about 34 degrees out here. 3 degrees centigrade. So 36 Fahrenheit. It is cold, but anyway, it was a success. Well, there you go, guys. That's with 80 cc injectors in him. He was pulling 25 psi at boost, which is pretty good. It was a good run. Next run, we're gonna do it inside. I'll clean this junk up this week, get some new hoses for this thing. And yeah, it should be a lot of fun. But I am frozen. I'm cold, man, I tell you. But yeah, successful dyno run, guys. Happy times. And again, thanks for checking in. And we'll catch you on the next video. Take care.